Aki was a devil hunter that was seeking revenge against the Gun Devil, because the Gun Devil killed his family when he was just a child. Then how, if Aki hated the Gun Devil, why did he become the Gun Devil? That's a question that I've seen a lot of on social media, and on this video I will explain you how everything ended up being like this. Aki hated the devils. He didn't like working with Denji and Power. So in chapter 11 of Chainsaw Man, Makima is the one asking Aki to be closer to the devil. So even if Aki didn't like them, since Makima was the one who asked him, he always said that Makima saved him and he really respects her and even likes her. So he accepts what Makima says and tries to be closer to Denji and Power. So when we get to know that the Gun Devil wants Denji's heart, it's when Aki starts caring more about Denji, because he's important to find the Gun Devil. And it's in this time when Aki develops a closer relationship with Denji and Power. When he was at the hospital after fighting Katana Man, he gets an offer to quit public safety and just enjoy his life, but he refuses to do it and he goes to make a contract with the future devil. So the future devil just asks Aki to put his head inside his chest so he can see his future. So when he knows how Aki will die, he says that he won't ask Aki for anything important. He just wants to watch how he dies, because he will die in the worst possible way. So the contract in the end is just the future devil being at Aki's right eye until the day he dies, so he can watch that moment personally. So during these parts of Chainsaw Man is when we see the relationship of Denji and Aki getting better. They seem to hate each other, but we get the moment when they start kicking Katana Man in the balls after they defeat him. And it's probably one of the times when we see that they begin being more like friends and less like enemies, trying to impress Makima. So remember that I said before that Aki hated the devils, and how did he finish working and being literally the friend of Denji if he hated him from the beginning? It's because Makima wanted this to happen, and she built everything since the very beginning of the story. We see in the end when Makima is talking about Denji, about all the things that she did. She talks that she gave Denji money, she gave him food, she gave him a family. Aki was a big brother to him, and Power a little sister. And she did everything just to make Denji happy, and then destroy everything that he had just to make him suffer. So everything that happened so far and all the interactions between them were all built up by Makima. After the encounter with the Darkness Devil is when we see that the future devil tells Aki that he and Power will be killed by Chainsaw Man, and he tells this to Angel, and Angel says that the future can't be changed. So they go and try to find Makima, because he thinks that maybe Makima could know a way to avoid the death of Aki. So when Aki and the Angel Devil find Makima at the beach, Aki says that whatever happens, he just wants Denji and Power to survive and be happy, because Aki really starts caring about them after all the things that happened between them. And Aki says that he will make any contract any devil if that devil is able to help him to save his friends. And Makima says, in that case, will you make a contract with me? If you give me all of you, I will give you the strength to save your friends. And suddenly the speech of Makima changes, and she says that it's an order, and forces Aki to say that he will make a contract. And it's in that time that Angel has a flashback and remembers what Makima did to him when she met him. And we see that he's just there seeing the girl that he liked, and later when Makima makes him show her his power, suddenly everyone appears dead nearby him. So after this flashback of Angel, we see that Aki is already being controlled, and he says, I will make a contract. It really reminded me of when Makima touched Toka, and he suddenly starts talking that he will give everything to make everyone escape from hell. Angel tries to stop Makima, but he's too weak compared to the control devil, and Makima just defeats him and makes him say that he will give all of him for her. So everything is about to happen, and we see the Gun Devil for the first time in action. I mean, we saw him before, we never saw the actual body. The Gun Devil just starts killing everything nearby him. It's the same scene of the first chapters of the manga when we see the travel of the Gun Devil until he kills the family of Aki. So we get all these gore scenes when everyone is getting killed, and we see the name of the victims across the screen. So when the Gun Devil finally finds Makima, he tries to attack her and he kills her. And in one of the panels we see that Aki is in the list of people killed by the Gun Devil. It's in this time that Aki dies and he's killed by the Gun Devil, but because he was being controlled by Makima. Makima was also killed by the Gun Devil, and somehow she's able to go back to life. After being alive again, she uses an ability, and she's able to use the devils of all the devil hunters that were nearby her. And we see that a lot of demons, or whatever they are with guns, come up from the sky and attack the Gun Devil. And in this scene of chapter 76, we don't get the outcome of the battle. We just see that the Gun Devil is getting a direct attack from Makima. So after this unknown outcome, we see that Makima calls Denji, and she says that the Gun Devil appeared without warning. They failed to defeat him, and the Gun Devil just took over a dead body and got away. But we don't have any way to know if this is true and Makima is telling the truth. And she says that the Gun Fiend is now ringing his doorbell. So as it was explained before in the manga in the first episode, when Aki was explaining to Denji about what was a fiend, we can see that a fiend is when a devil possesses the body of a dead person. And I've seen many people call Aki the Gun Devil, but if we analyze this, he's a Gun Fiend, not a Gun Devil, because it's just the devil taking over Aki's corpse. So we can see that everything was built up by Makima, and if we analyze the situation, it's just too weird that the Gun Devil just chose Aki over all the people just by pure luck. It's obvious that Makima wanted Aki to become the Gun Fiend so she could make him confront Denji, and this battle will hurt him a lot because it was the plan of her since the very beginning of the manga. She wanted to break the heart of Denji, and that's why she made Aki get killed like this, and she also killed Power in the following episodes. Aki lived such a tragic life, and he always wanted revenge on the Gun Devil, but due to what Makima did, he ended up being a Gun Fiend, and it's a really shocking plot twist. And it's in this situation that we really get to know why the future devil say that he will die in the worst possible way, because he got killed by his friend. He almost tried to kill his other friend. That's why we see the future devil at the scene when Aki is finally killed by Denji, that he's laughing off, and after he witnessed everything, he just goes away. So in the end, everything for Aki was a tragedy. He died in a very sad way. He never chose to become a fiend, and at least I think that he was happy in some points of his life. And I also think that Snow Fight is a way to see that somehow he was able to find his family once again. Maybe the snowball fight is just a way to represent those moments before you die where you seek happiness inside of you. And it's beautiful to see that Aki was able to find a new family, and he died while playing with them for one last time.